welcome to the show, everybody. My name's Larry Herb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. You've downloaded one of the longest-running podcasts on planet Earth. Joining me is Jeff Rubenstein across this tiny little, it looks like an end table.
It is.
We're in the studio, and it feels like
it has an alarm clock. It has a mug with some water in it.
Got some notes. Anyway, how you doing?
I'm doing great. You know, I've seen you turn into Larry that I was talking to 30 seconds ago versus Larry once, as soon as they hit that record button.
As soon as the on-the-air light goes on, we are on the air. It's just
the car shifts straight into fifth, and your Xbox Live's like, Major Nelson.
I'm like an electric car. All the torque, immediately.
I have range anxiety.
You have a lot of anxiety.
That's true.
But anyway, we're here. It's August. It's early to slash mid August. If you're in the northwest of the United States, it feels like summer maybe just got started, and it's almost over.
It's over. it's cloudy and rainy today.
This is not fun.
We had a good week and a half.
Having fun. We're back in the studio again. We wanted to jump back in here because we're just on the cusp of Gamescom again. Feels like we just got back from Cologne.
I feel like I just ran out of gummy bears, which I did.
Which we did.
So I got to make another run.
For those of you who don't know what that reference is, there's a specific gummy bear company, and no, it's not Haribo. Everyone asks that. It is Baron Company.
Baron Company.
And it is only available in this particular region of Germany, and is, as I stand here, somebody who is a fan of chewy candies, and sour candies, this is top. Notch.
I thought you were going to say it's the Cadillac of gummy bears, but I was going to correct it to like the BMW.
It is. Do you agree with me?
Oh, they're the best.
Yeah.
And I was someone who used to be like, "What are you eating? You should be eating Haribos. Those are the good ones." And then I had these, and now
as somebody,
I scoff at Haribo.
As somebody who you have introduced, you and I share a lot of culinary good finds, and you've shared more than your share. I feel good that I've at least put you onto a little something, because you put me onto Topo Chico.
And you have not looked back.
No.
I feel like you're on the board.
I am all Topo Chico all the time. Topo Chico is a mineral water that is sold in parts of the country. I don't know how much of the country it's sold in. It's from Monterrey,
Mexico.
It's
been in Texas forever.
Yeah.
And I think they were recently acquired by, it might be Coke, I don't even know. And now all of a sudden you can get it as far from Mexico as you can get in the United States up here in the Northwest.
If you like carbonation, this is your jam. You'll remove that bottle from your lips and go, wow.
And then you can put it, you don't finish it, you put it in the fridge, you come back 3 days later, it's still fizzy. How do they do it?
I don't know. It's magical. All right, so that's the food portion of the podcast. What are you playing, Jeff? We're here to talk about games and Xbox news and let's see, do we have... I know why the table's smaller.
Why?
They had to sell the larger one to pay Ninja.
Not touching that. Welcome Ninja to Mixer. Yeah. I've been watching him a lot more, I would say, in the past couple of weeks since he joined last week.
Yep.
It's been great seeing, first of all, just how many subs he's getting and how many people are jumping in and sort of getting behind him and how many people he has brought to the platform. But it's also just great to see the great response from other Mixer creators who I've worked with.
You work with a lot of them, don't you?
I do. Yeah. And it just seems like it's good for everybody.
Yeah.
So I have not gotten to meet Tyler yet, but hopefully that'll happen at some point. And, I look forward to it.
Actually,
Yeah.
I think I've got a meeting with him coming up. I'll tell you about that off the air.
Okay.
I can't share it on the air.
Got to put Ninja and Major Nelson together.
Yeah, well, we'll figure it out. Maybe we'll do a co-stream. We'll figure something out.
That would be pretty cool.
He's having a good time, so he's good. Welcome, Tyler.
He is welcome. We're talking about what we're playing.
Yes.
So I'm getting ready for, among many, many other things, but as a gamer, the Borderlands 3.
Right. Coming up. It's a month away.
It is. Almost to the date. And there's no better way to get ready for Borderlands 3 than to fire up Borderlands 2 and play the DLC.
Which you've been doing.
We completed. It's called Commander Lilith, and it basically sets up what you're going to be doing in Borderlands 3. And I hadn't played 2. I was popping the first achievements in 2.5 years.
Really?
Yeah, it's been a long time since I played 2.
Yeah, it has been. You played it with a friend. You had a house guest over.
We didn't land them together, but it just took over the dining room table, put up a couple Xboxes and monitors on there, and we just played
through. You're off to the races.
You have to play Borderlands co-op. There's just...
How else do you play it? You know, it's funny. Back in the day when the first one came out, it was that's where Team Dysfunction came from.
I've heard about this.
It was me and Eric E and Steptoe and Laura, and it was mind-numbing fun. We had a great time with that one. We were all running every.
It's going to be co-op fall.
Yeah.
You know, I know your hot boy summer that's wrapping up.
Yeah.
Straight into co-op fall because we're going to have to play that.
Yeah.
But then we also have to play. Gears together.
Which is right after that, yep.
And actually, hot off the presses, we're going to jump all over. I actually have gotten a hold of, it should be out there by the time you hear this, the achievement list.
You have?
For Gears 5.
I have not even seen this. Wow.
There are 71 achievements, which span campaign, escape, versus horde, and the map builder, because you can build maps for modes like escape, and more.
Right.
So, of course, the first one you have to look at is, I'm waiting for you to tell me.
Go ahead.
What achievement is Gears famous for?
Seriously. Yeah.
So we're up to Seriously 5.0. Worth 100 gamer score, easily the most in the game. Complete insane campaign, master horde, escape, master the horde and escape launch maps and characters, get 20 re-ups, and reach general ranking in Tour of Duty.
All right.
So that's a lot of stuff. There's all kinds of leveling up in the different modes. And so there's quite a lot here. I'm looking at the ones, Horde, I'm going to be able to do this because I love to play Horde. It's probably the mode I'll play the most.
Yep.
And of course, you want to get to 50 and doing that in any difficulty will get you an achievement. Of course, if you can do it... you know, you can do in higher levels, then that's worth more.
And I'm sure this is available by the time this airs. It'll be available.
It'll be on Xbox Wire and Xbox Achievements
I'll link to it from my blog.
Yeah, those are good. Escape is a really fun mode that I played at E3, as did many other folks. And I'm looking forward to, we should do that. So that's going to be a fun co-op mode for us.
It's
optimized for three people. And that'll be really good. Horde is, of course, optimized for five people.
We've got a three people because we've been playing with three people with Apex since March.
Exactly.
Right?
It's three is the new...
three four? Is the new four.
Yeah.
Or two.
Whatever. But if you ever have an odd person out, you can always make it work here. And then, of course, there's tons... if you're just someone who cares about the campaign, I'm very much looking forward to this campaign.
I'm not hearing much about that.
Well, I mean, you're going to be hearing more about it. I mean, the game is out in under a month. If you're an Xbox Live Ultimate member or you pre-order the Ultimate Edition, you'll be playing that on September 6th.
Ooh, you know what I have is I have a little bit of news about kind of Gears related. We will have the head of the coalition, Mr. Rod Ferguson, on the show in the past. He'll be joining us at our annual PAX panel here in Seattle. When PAX, our panel is the 31st, Saturday the 31st.
Saturday, that's the good day.
Yeah. They always give us a good slot on
that's
a good
nice.
Day.
How
good
do you, place. How did you earn that?
I don't know. I'll just don't tell anybody.
We've got it.
I'll have more details on that as we get closer.
Yeah. We'll have to figure out what, I think we're in a streaming room this year.
Are we?
So even if you're not in Seattle, you'll be able to watch
it live.
So
we're in a stream room? So I can show up and just, a stream room, not a steam room.
It's not a sauna, Larry. I just watched that episode of Stranger Things yesterday. It's a good episode.
Have you finished that yet?
I've got two more to go. This is a really good season.
Yeah, I know.
The first couple episodes, a little too backtracky. Once you hit episode, I think it was episode 4, just like blew me away. That was one of the best hours of TV of the year. Just there was three... You had ABC like storylines. Everyone's trying to uncover stuff, and things go crazy
things
all
go,
at the same
don't,
time.
Don't, no really, spoilers. No spoilers.
I think that's.
I have this. Enough. I have this in my Spotify here. I haven't published this, but somebody posted this thing called Mallsoft. Have you heard about this?
No.
It's a playlist of background music from malls in the 80s.
But you can hear the people as if you're sitting at the food court at the Orange Julius. Oh,
it's,
my God.
Anyway, so it's kind of...
Malls in the 80s are a little funky.
Well, it's 80s and 90s, so it's called Mallsoft.
You're bringing me back. I feel like I'm in the Coral Square Mall.
Is that where it was? Florida.
They had an arcade. I played Mortal Kombat there.
Go
to the software, et cetera.
What was mine? Mine was the West Farms Mall in West Hartford, Connecticut, which...
They have a Microsoft store.
I opened it. That's why that was the one I used to hang out as a kid. And I said, I'm going to open that store. And sure enough, how many years later, I cut the ribbon on the Microsoft store at the mall I used to hang out in.
Revenge best served cold lay.
I don't know if that was revenge.
I don't know if it's revenge.
But yeah, it's funny.
You called your shot.
The reason, because you said it was software, et cetera.
Yeah.
That Microsoft store, that's where it was.
In that spot?
In that spot, roughly there. And I think it was the Sharper Image.
He was
going
to say, it would have to be bigger than that.
But yeah, I remember Sharper Image was on that corner. And I don't know what else was there. But yeah, that was a, all right, enough about.
They probably had a Wet Seal or I think it was like 80s and 90s stores.
Yeah. Spencer Gifts. Get your black light and your novelty items.
A plushie for the old high school girlfriend.
Oh, boy. Anyway, welcome to, we should do an 80s podcast. Well, maybe I should.
I'd be more in a 90s podcast, right. I feel like.
That's okay.
80s have orange-tinted memories for me.
As well. So here we are. Anyway, so we're talking about Stranger Things.
What we're playing, yes. So the DLC. Yeah. I'm getting ready. Can't wait for Horde Mode. I finished playing A Plague Tale Innocence.
Yeah, the rat game.
The rat.
A.K.A.
The rat game. It takes place during the 100 Years' War between France and England, but which was also the same time as the plague. It was not a great time to be alive in France, as it seems. That was a great, great game. So it's sort of like an action stealth game. I think we've talked about it a little bit. You've never seen more rats in your life, I assure you, even if you've seen this season of Stranger Things.
Yep.
Still more rats than that. So that being said, really enjoyed this game. It gave me a different viewpoint into that era, because I'd read about it, but you just like
I know that you adore your costume French drama.
I'm a real Renaissance man.
You are.
Actually, this would be before the Renaissance, so I painted myself into a corner.
Maybe that's why you were unaware of this era, because you were in the wrong era.
It's true. Needless to say, made me really appreciate that we live in this century and not in the 14th century.
Right.
It had to smell. It had to smell.
That's all you can say is it had to smell.
That's all I can not think of. Food is like, how great. Gross is it?
There was a
the
lot
food,
of
these. There's, I don't know if they were eating berries off of bushes.
And
they were
wet gray meat.
I'm gonna leave that alone, Larry. Larry's not a big fan of bowls of
wet
soup and beef.
Meat.
It's good. It's good. Also, last game, Kingdom Two Crowns. I've just spent a lot of time playing this game. And my kid has gotten into it, so we're playing it split screen. And that's the two crowns in Kingdom Two Crowns. It's in Xbox Game Pass. It's a two-dimensional city builder strategy where all day you sort of build up your kingdom and all night you try to fend off these horrible greed monsters and pray that you don't get a blood moon, because if that happens, it really screws up your day.
Oh, the blood moon.
Screws up your day.
Oh,
I promise
Link.
You. It did in Zelda, and it certainly does in Kingdom Two Crowns.
Right.
Good game. And one more game I just started getting back into last night. And
yes.
Another co-op game. Well, I'm looking forward to Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Breakpoint. Hoping to see it at Gamescom when I'm out there. But I never finished Wildlands.
Oh, yeah.
And that was a great game.
Great
and they,
game.
They, the amazing DLC. Remember, right. they had Sam Fisher. We had him on the first Inside Xbox or second Inside Xbox. So I want to go back through and start playing that again. I was just looking through my achievements. It's been a couple of years, and I don't know. Something distracted me. It looks like it was probably E3, just looking at the timing of this, and I didn't go back to it. It's time to go back to it.
By the way, we talked about being August.
Yeah.
You know what that means.
Madden time?
Yes, it is.
I downloaded it.
Okay.
I'm ready for it. I have EA access. It's
you
part
and
of that.
You and
I just downloaded it
and
play
X
amount
of
hours. We need to go head to head. I'm feeling real good about the Eagles this year.
Okay.
And I think I'm going to beat you this year.
Okay. This could be, we keep saying this, and based on my timing at home, is we should just co-stream it and be done with it.
We should do that. Here's the other thing. Gronk retired, so I don't know what you're going to be doing.
Yeah, exactly.
You're out of options because you just ran that money play over and over and over again. He just caught everything.
Hail Mary, Hail
Mary,
Hail Mary.
He was just like David Tyree after David Tyree.
There's only one Hail Mary play now.
What's that?
I mean, that's in Madden, there used to be three.
Oh, really?
Now there's just one.
Now it's just they just run down to the end.
Yeah, yeah. So
the Philly special. So let's do that. Let's do that this weekend.
Yeah.
Or maybe tomorrow. Yeah, maybe on Friday.
Maybe
we'll
on
figure
Friday.
It out.
Maybe
that would
Friday,
be good.
So maybe Saturday. Maybe
soon. Okay.
Soon.
Well, let's do
soon.
For real. Let's do it.
Yeah. For real.
And then, of course, you and I have been playing just a whole lot of season two of Apex.
Apex Legends. Happening.
It's so good. Yeah. And they're introducing solos next week. I don't know how. I'm gonna give it a shot. I feel like the team based is like the
it's a sweet
my
spot.
Favorite part of the game. I think three people. It really works well.
Right.
But solos is very popular in Fortnite. So hey, why not? Maybe it is. Maybe it'll work real well.
I'm playing Wolfenstein Youngblood.
Yeah, how do you like that?
I'm just going through it. Is that you?
That is not me.
Okay, that must be me.
Sorry, oh, it's you.
Sorry about that. That was my Outlook reminding me I had to be somewhere. Apparently recording the show.
You're late, Larry.
That's not Malt
We
Soft.
Started 10 minutes ago.
Wolfenstein Youngblood. That's I'm playing that a little bit.
That more 80s there for you.
That is, speaking of 80s.
Do you hear the mall music there? Yeah, I know. Is the mall music different in the alternate universe?
No, I haven't gotten to the mall in Wolfenstein yet, and I'm frankly
I don't know if there is one, afraid. But there would have to be.
Still swimming around in Assassin's Creed Odyssey, because that game is the game that just keeps giving.
Are you playing the DLC?
I need to, but I haven't gotten to it yet. I haven't finished the game.
It's really good.
Stranger Things 3, The Game?
Yeah.
That's out. I played a little bit of that.
It's more like 16-bit, right?
Yeah. Yeah, it's a little bit of that going on. Sea of Solitude, we talked about that last game, which is from EA. It's an indie game from EA.
Mm-hmm.
Two words you don't hear frequently together, indie games and EA.
they have throughout the years. You know, Yarny was one. Fae, F-E, or whatever it was.
Right, right.
So they're no stranger to, you know, more introspective game.
Yep. So that's anyway, so we're still going on, but we're getting ready for all those games that Jeff was just talking about.
Yeah. Oh, you just made me think about FIFA when you mentioned EA.
Yeah.
Soccer starts. This is if you're hearing this Friday, it's the first day of the English Premier League.
So that means Saturday morning I can start texting you at 0600, right?
Actually, kickoff is at 5:55 a.m. and I will be awake. Newcastle, okay. Arsenal, Newcastle. I'm excited.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully that excitement lets me wake up and not hit snooze at 5:55 a.m. But
5:54.
Yeah, I think they walk around for a minute or two and then they blow the whistle.
I'm talking about
six.
You.
Oh, yeah. I'll probably just be up all night.
It's like Christmas for you, isn't it?
It is. It's just like the best day of the year.
Good for you.
We're not in last place. And because Arsenal alphabetically is at the top of the list, it's the only day we're in first place.
Okay.
After that,
it's all downhill.
It's not going to be great. Actually, we should be good this year.
So what else we got? We got a little bit of news coming up here. Oh, you know, we talked about usually you go over and see the football because the season starts. Gamescom. Gamescom is coming up in a couple weeks.
And you can join us in many, many ways.
Many, 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 many ways.
So one of them is the way that if you're joining us, you know, on this podcast, it's probably the way you would join us. And that'll be tuning in on Monday, August 19th at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 Eastern, or 5 p.m. Central Eastern.
Yep.
Standard time, I think. I don't know what that ST is, but that is when Inside Xbox Live from Cologne. That's going to be taking place from the Gloria Theater. And the cool thing about it is once the show is over, we're just going to keep the Gloria Theater open all week. And you'll be able to join us Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. That's August 21st through 23rd for Xbox Open Doors. It's free. You can just come on in. We'll have community events. We'll have game tournaments. There'll be panel sessions and other fun stuff. So I'm going to drop by there. It is away from the hustle and bustle of the Köln Messe, which is the Messe where you have all the...
the main convention.
This is the main thing, but it's crazy. There's just hundreds of thousands of people there. This will be a more intimate Xbox-focused environment and should be really fun. Of course, if you're at the Köln Messe, the Xbox booth will have 200 gaming sessions. I saw the list of the games.
Is it?
There's stuff there that I have not yet gotten to play, so I'm super excited. I'll be getting there early to quote-unquote set up, a.k.a. I should test this out for you.
And
there's a lot of stuff I'm looking forward to playing. Of course, we'll have games on both Xbox and on PC, a huge PC gaming market out there in Central Europe. And so, I mean, so many of our games, Game Pass is on Xbox One and PC. Did you see that? I caught that.
You caught electrical cord coming out of your computer.
That was really weird.
You were flying your hands around.
I'm a hand talker, even on a podcast.
Gamescom, that's the details. You'll see more and more details coming over the next couple weeks as we kind of get a little more granular about what we just talked about. You're going, unfortunately, I'm not going this year. I've got a personal conflict, so you guys are going to have to carry the mantle forward.
When you say carry the mantle, you mean bring back those gummy bears.
See the top of the show.
All right. Well, yes. So I'm going to check a bag.
Okay, because you were like, oh, I don't know if I'm going to check a bag or not, which I would love to not be able to check a bag when I travel, but
I'm going
to
do it for the bears. For the Baron. They, you know, when they're doing their yearly forecast.
Right.
They're like, okay, you know, Easter's big and Christmas is big.
And there's a huge bump in August. We don't know what it is, but let's staff up.
Yeah. So they've probably made, I'm sure we'll go in there, just be boxes and boxes of gummy bears, you know, waiting for
you. And a lot of folks are asking, no, as far as I can tell, they do not ship out of the country that I can tell.
If they do, it's probably exorbitant for shipping. But you asked me, could you mind just repeating your order for the public?
Well, there's these cherry cola ones, sours, which are quite good. And I don't know, I believe I asked for 10 to 12.
10 to 12 bags. Each one of these bags is like 500 grams or something like that. It is not light. So that's why I'm checking a bag. It may be overweight.
Okay, I'll pay for the overweight.
I'm doing it. Okay. All right, well, maybe. Yeah, I think I spent 40 euros last year. So with yours in there,
right,
we're going to be right around the $100 mark in gummy bears.
You may have to claim something.
I know. Customs, do you have anything to declare? A sugar high?
Exactly. All of this?
I did link out to Baron Company in case you want to take a look. You want to
we'll put that in the show notes.
Yeah. I really don't even think there's an English version
No, there is no English version because they don't care. They're like, here it is.
We're doing fine.
We're doing fine. We don't need you.
We're getting our August bonus.
Anyway, so yeah, that's Gamescom. I'll have more details on the blog, and I'll be tweeting out about that as well. We got that followed by, and later on that day, there's Jeff Keighley's show. I talked to Jeff a couple days ago. He's got his show going on.
Okay.
So he'll have, I'm sure he'll have some Xbox.
Yeah, I think there's just a lot going on that.
It's a busy, busy day that Monday.
It's good to see. I don't know if he hasn't been out of Gamescom recently, I don't
know. No,
think.
At least not. He and I were texting back. I told him I wasn't going to be able to make it, and he was bummed because we've done that show quite a bit together.
Okay.
We'll
be watching that too.
And then right out of that, we come back, and then we get ready for PAX like we talked about.
Get ready for PAX, then we get ready for Gears.
Yeah.
So it's and that NBA is out around that time. Borderlands is out around that time. It's going to be the next month.
Yeah.
Probably the busiest of the year for us.
Now, you've got some headlines coming up here. You got some news in front of you, right?
Yeah,
I do. In case you missed it.
We announced the best looking Xbox One X that we have ever created.
Which is?
That's not hyperbole.
No.
That is the Xbox One X Gears 5 Limited Edition Bundle. If you haven't seen it, I will link out to it on majornelson.com. This is, we released a video. I don't remember the last time we ever released a video with like in-game CG footage of the game that is represented. This isn't just product shots. Of the inspiration. And so we're going to be, Gears 5 is going to take place in some chilly environments. And there is, that's what this box represents, this Xbox. It looks like it's a frozen lake of some sort. And underneath it, there's an omen underneath the ice. And it is a translucent case. The ice is cracking. And then it comes with a Kate Diaz limited edition controller, which is sold separately. If you choose to have it, it's part of the bundle, but you can also buy it. If you just want the controller, you can buy that. And it looks like Kate's armor, that winter armor that she's wearing in this video. So if you want to see the video, if you want to see the controller, if you want to pre-order it, if you want it, there's
a
charging stand.
Yeah, charging stand. We've got
there's
a headset.
That looks nice. Yeah. And there's even a branded Razer wireless keyboard and mouse.
I got to get one of those.
Yeah. How do you not have that? And even a hard drive, a Seagate... how many terabytes is this? Oh, it doesn't... 5 terabytes.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. So that's... You're all set. And it matches the controller, and it looks really cool too. So I'll link out to that. There's just all of the Gears beauty, but I'm glad that, you know, a game like this, which is always been known for, despite being in like... I worked on Gears 1.
You did.
Ultimate Edition.
The Ultimate Edition.
And we talked about the game's destroyed beauty. And I think there's another game. It's beautiful yet terrifying at the same time. I'm glad to see Gears get such an awesome advanced, and I really don't think we've ever made like this cool of an Xbox One X. So
beautiful.
I'll link out to that.
World's most powerful console.
It's true. Something that I'm looking forward to playing during the long ride between Seattle and Cologne, Germany, the Bard's Tale trilogy. We work with In Exile now. They're part of the Xbox, the Microsoft family, the Xbox Studios family. And this is one of the first games to sort of come out of that. And that is the Bard's Tale trilogy. They've been making these games since the 80s. And so it's, the first three on both Xbox One and on Windows 10. These are like, it's a very like sort of old school dungeon crawling RPG experience. They're remastered with updated graphics, but it still has like that 8-bit spirit from the original one. I'll link out to what that looks like. They're also, of course, working on the Wasteland 30th Anniversary Edition. So we'll be talking about that. That's arriving later this year. Wasteland 3 is coming down the line. And then after the Bard's Tale trilogy later in the month, maybe I'm I don't know, my way back from PAX or something, is the Bard's Tale 4 Director's Cut. And this is a more modern looking
RPG. All the Bard's Tale you'd ever want.
So a lot of RPGs. If you're an RPG fan, In Exile is really taking care of you this year.
And I know you're playing something on your Switch right now, aren't you?
Not I am. RPG. Fire Emblem. I'm a huge Fire Emblem fan. This is Fire Emblem Three Houses, sort of Fire Emblem meets. So if it was like to explain to a layman, like Shining Force or even XCOM meets Harry Potter.
Right.
And so you spend like your days throughout the month sort of working with your students and the other teachers and leveling them up and creating relationships with them, professional relationships with them, recruiting other students. What does that look like, Larry? And then you fight. At the end of the month, you fight.
Right.
And it's pretty awesome. Fight. So I'll be playing that on the... As a RPG and a strategy guy, it's a golden age.
It is.
I'm getting to play games that I never played back in the 80s and 90s. I'm getting to play
brand new stuff. We were in the 80s because you were hanging out at the mall.
Well, it's true.
Right.
Yeah, the original Bard's Tale came out in 1985 and had two sequels. And then Bard's Tale 4 looks really good. I'm very excited for that. Especially as someone who played Operencia.
Yeah.
It definitely looks like that.
Yeah.
That style of game.
Lovely.
So what are you going to be playing this weekend, Larry?
We're going to be playing Madden.
We are going to play
Madden. I got to figure out my new strategy.
But if you want to try something else and you don't want to spend any money,
what?
We can all stand to save some money from time to time. Sure. Vigor is going to have a free weekend from the time you hear us through August 11th. So that started on Thursday at midnight. It's going all the way through to just about 11:59 p.m. Pacific-ish on Sunday. So you really have the whole weekend. There's a big update that hit recently, the 0.9 update. It's part of an Xbox game preview. So this is, it will become free to play at some point this summer, but it's not there yet. You can play it now and enjoy a cool European made shooting game. Vigor.
Vigor. Yes, I can see you're drawing a breath for even more news.
Yeah, I just wanted to say Age of Wonders Planetfall is now available. It is it's an empire building game in like a sci-fi setting. Looks pretty cool. And so I definitely recommend you take a look at it. It's
Build
available for Xbox One on the Microsoft Store.
Are you building your empire?
I'm looking at it. I might be picking it up. Yeah, this looks very much my speed.
Okay.
Age of Empires this weekend, as well, is going to have an Age 2, Definitive Edition campaign weekend. So if you're part of that beta, you're going to want to look out for that. If you're not part of the beta, well, you can register as an Age Insider for a chance to access the Age of Empires 2 Definitive Edition beta and join for this campaign weekend. I will link to that. You're going to want to get on that quickly. It's for Age Insiders with a connected Steam account and there's some other stuff, but I'll send you over to the Age of Empires site with a direct link, and that should help you out. Age 2, that was the classic one. I mean, Age 1 was classic too, but Age 2 is like, that was huge. That game was huge. No Man's Sky.
Yeah, what an update.
Huge update.
Massive.
Second year in a row with just a major, major, major update. Yeah, so we had one last summer, and then next week, August 14th, we have No Man's Sky, Beyond.
Beyond.
And, it is a pretty big update. I'm going to link out. There's a trailer. There's a lot of multiplayer stuff. There's a dramatically expanded multiplayer experience. So you can really sort of have those cool experiences you have in No Man's Sky when you encounter another traveler, but you can like adventure and explore together. A lot of other new social features. They took inspiration from other multiplayer games and MMOs. And it's something to look out for next week. We'll have to try that out. I played a lot of No Man's Sky when it hit Xbox last year.
Yeah, that was fun getting off that planet and just kind of trying to figure it out. That was really kind of cool.
That moment of discovery was something they definitely nailed.
Right.
Actually, it kind of reminded me in a little bit. I know one of the games that you were playing
quite a bit of was
Outer Wilds.
Outer Wilds, yeah.
And they actually just announced a new patch, or they just released a new patch that... does a few different things. You can sleep at campfires to fast forward time.
Oh, I'll have to check that out.
Some updated, there's a number of fixes, but the key thing is 4K support for Xbox One X. It is now an Xbox One X enhanced title.
So good, that game.
And between that and the fact that you can customize the field of view, the FOV, I think that's pretty cool.
Yeah. Those guys did a great job with that.
And this is a game that a lot of people really, I think this is a game we're going to be talking about at the end of the year.
Right.
With game of the year type connotations. People really,
I absolutely love that game. It just was one that just kept, I don't know why, it just keeps me going back. And I'm just looking at the patch notes right here.
And I'll link out to those. And yeah, it's part of Xbox Game Pass. So what more do you need?
Yeah, what are you doing?
You should be downloading it right now as you're listening to the dying embers of this episode.
I see what you did there.
It's a segue.
Crackling, crackling, crackling.
Oh, yeah, there's that too. By the way, if you load up that game for the first time, first thing you need to do, you want to get that achievement, you just walk right into that fire.
Mm-hmm.
And you just let it do its thing.
Mm-hmm.
You just respawn. It's no big deal. Then you come back. You go back to that fire.
Mm-hmm.
You pick up a stick. You roast some marshmallows. You eat 10 of them.
Mm-hmm.
That's your gamer score tip. Two achievements right there in like 1 minute.
Look at this. This is all right. So there you go. There's absolutely zero more value we can add in this show. Jeff, you just peaked it.
I want to get you free games.
Yep.
I want to get you easy achievements.
Yep. That's what we're all about here.
And I want to get you drinking Topo Chico.
I can't disagree with any of that.
It's the service I'm here to provide.
Anyway, we're hey, what else we got?
As far as news is concerned,
yeah,
that's it for now. Mm-hmm. Obviously, we have a lot of stuff. Looking forward to the Inside Xbox episode that we talked about for Gamescom. Looking forward to PAX. Looking forward to a bunch of games coming out in September. There's a lot there, but that's about all I can say right now.
Yeah, we've got a lot coming on. We're gonna. We wanted to jump in and we're supposed to have a couple of guests on the show, but unfortunately, due to work, they canceled. You know, it's interesting because a lot of people think, well, the summer's kind of quiet, and it is for games, but on the platform side, the platform meaning like the Xbox. You know, the Xbox dashboard and all of that, they're real busy because they're getting ready for, you know, we're already talking about the holiday release, right? We're in these holiday meetings, and holiday is November and December for us to get ready for the next, you know, update and whatnot and all the rest of the stuff. We got a lot going on. We've got Gamescom, we've got PAX, we've got all these game releases. Later on in the year, we have XO, which we've announced. Jeff and I and co are going to London. I'm going back to London and you'll be going. So maybe you'll be able to catch some footy out there then.
Yeah, I'm hoping to. I think I'll get out there twice this year. Just yeah. Really, it's a matter. Will the schedule cooperate?
Will it cooperate? One can only.
I know you're hanging there with bated breath. Will I get to go yell at my favorite players?
That's all I want. I just want to make sure you've got the scarf on.
Bring some of that American booing.
Yeah, the scarf.
To the UK. They whistle when they're not happy.
Oh, really? Yeah. Give me a sad whistle. Give me an upset whistle.
I can't do that. I boo like an American. I'm from Philly. We boo.
That's right. You do.
No melody.
And throw things.
Yeah. Well, I know better than to, you know, wing a 9-volt battery in another country.
We're gonna wrap it up now, so we'll let you guys go. Thank you for downloading the show. Thank you for all your support. You can follow Jeff Rubenstein on Twitter at
Jeff Rubenstein. You messed up your line.
I know. Well, no, I'm saying if you have any complaints.
There it is.
Or you have negative feedback or your console is giving you a problem.
I feed off of negativity.
Or you're unclear about game patch notes.
I'm here for you. I answer them all.
He's a man. If you have any other things, feel free to direct them my way. You can find me at Major Nelson. We'll talk to you guys after Gamescom, maybe hopefully before PAX. If not, if you're coming to PAX, we would love to see you. Talk off Saturday afternoon and join me and Jeff and Rod. And we'll talk gears and we'll have some fun. All right, gang, have a great time, and we'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Bye.